Hey guys, what's up? So if you are starting your own clothing line and need a tech pack to send to your manufacturer, or if you simply want to put a tech pack into your portfolio to show off to recruiters, then this video is for you. So let's dive right into the art of creating a tech pack. A tech pack, simply put, is a detailed guide for your manufacturer to create your garment. I have a menswear hoodie here, which I designed based on an edgy streetwear theme. And I'm gonna show you my six and only pages in my hoodie's tech pack. So firstly, a colorway sheet showing the colored front and back sketch of my hoodie. Second, a construction details sheet that shows the black and white flat sketch of my hoodie with additional labels to tell my manufacturer that this is how I want it to be constructed. Third, an artwork sheet that shows the artwork that I designed, its placement, its technique, its colors, and its dimension. Fourth, a branding sheet which shows what labels and hang tags my hoodie should have. Fifth, a spec sheet which details out the lengths and widths of different parts of my hoodie. And finally, sixth, the BOM or the bill of materials which keeps track of every raw material I have used. That's it. Just six pages. Now let's go through each page in depth, starting with the colorway sheet. Now when you make a tech pack, here are a few standards you absolutely need to follow. Make sure that you are working on Adobe Illustrator on an A4 size sheet. You also need a header and footer on every single page. Your header is where your company's name or logo is listed, while your footer needs to be a sentence that goes like this. Basically a sentence that makes sure nobody misuses your tech pack unlawfully. I'm going to start by copying and pasting my colored hoodie sketch here. You will see that I have a third sketch, which is my hoodie with the front zip open. This is because I am highlighting additional details like the inner lining with the all-over print. Some tech packs will have the side view of a garment or even the top view of a garment, just to give additional clarity to the manufacturer as to how the final garment should turn out. Now, at the top, I am going to add a comprehensive table of details that will set the tone for the rest of the tech pack. Let's zoom in and check them out. First and foremost, one of the most important things in a tech pack, the style number. Now, there is a whole backstory on how brands give their designs style numbers, because this number is used to identify the product right from its design stage up to its production stage. It's the number that your design team, your pattern master, your sample maker, and your buyers, etc., will use throughout. Some companies even put the style number on the garments that are finally sold in store. Therefore, keep in mind that an organized style number system is needed for all your designs. Because here's the cool thing. My hoodie style number might look like BMKO201, but from this alone, privately within a company, anyone can say that B is the brand name, M is for menswear, K is for knits, O is for outerwear, and the 200 series are specifically meant for graphic sweatshirts. So figure out a similar system for your designs and stick to it throughout. Season and category is self-explanatory. For size, in India, we usually use the letter sizes from extra small to extra large. Your sample size, on the other hand, is the size in which your prototype will be made. Your sample size should be the median or the middle size of your size range. In my case, the middle size is medium. Most companies follow the same unless you are dealing with a plus size brand. Quantity is self-explanatory, and for the vendor, list your garment manufacturer's name. Moving to the right, style name and gender you already know. Now a colorway is the number of colors you are making of your garment. If I had one more white hoodie in this exact same design, it would become two colorways. But in this case, I am creating just one hoodie, so the colorway is one. My fit is oversized and my length is regular because that is how I want it. Description is a quick one-liner about my hoodie's most important features, and COO is the country of origin, like made in India, made in China, made in Bangladesh, etc. Now, I am adding one more table at the bottom, only for my fabrics, trims, and colors. Here, I am listing the exact fabric, fiber composition, and weight of my main body fabric, fabric 1, which is 100% cotton, French terry, 240 GSM. And a secondary fabric, fabric 2, which I want only for my waistband and sleeve cuff, which is 2x2 cotton elastane rib. Now, here's a quick fun fact. You actually don't always need to know what fabric you want for your garment. Sometimes I might have a fabric swatch with me, which I got from an awesome hoodie that I bought from Zara, with absolutely no idea about its name and composition and quality. In that case, I will just attach this fabric swatch to my tech pack and send it to my vendor, and he will help me identify that swatch. Apart from that, I can even simply speak to fabric mills and tell them to send me thick cotton swatch varieties that they have. And from that, I can decide to choose something for my hoodie. Coming back to my tech pack. Now that I am done highlighting my fabrics, I am elaborating the exact trims that I need, which is a YKK metal zipper and its puller type. This is also where you list buttons, hooks and eyes, sequins, tassels, Velcro, cord locks, draw cords, etc. And at the bottom, I have elaborated my lining fabric. On the right side are the Pantones that I have selected for my hoodie. Now, Pantone is considered the universal standard and the leading authority on color. So never just write black. Always list a Pantone number which you got from Pantone.com. When professionally done, design teams of companies buy and keep a Pantone book with them. These books come with tiny color chips in them. So the design team always carries this book around, always referring to it to figure out the color palette for a style. That is it for the first sheet of your tech pack. Now, the second sheet is the construction and details sheet. Now, pay close attention, guys, because if you get this right, all the magic happens. On this page, I have drawn my black and white flat sketches first, also called as, you know it, the technical sketches. I am then adding any labeling or annotations that I think will help my manufacturer. And last, I am adding any close-ups or zoomed-in drawings of areas that could use further explanation. For example, my welt pockets need bar tacks at both ends, my inner seams need to be overlocked, and my wash care label needs to be placed at the inner side seam, 3 inches up from the waistband. I am also specifically listing the dimensions of a few areas like my welt pocket and my cuff. Basically, go ahead and label the heck out of this sheet. Tell your manufacturer what stitches you want and where it should be placed. Do you want a cut and sew panel across the front chest of your hoodie? Do you want a kangaroo pocket? Do you want parts of your hoodie to be in inverted terry? How about a slit at the side seams? Label out every single thing so that your manufacturer has no doubts whatsoever. My third sheet is simple. It is the artwork sheet. This artwork, which goes on the back of my hoodie, I made on Illustrator itself, and I have listed the colors, technique, dimension, and placement. Be as specific as you can. You might have a second artwork, like my lining artwork, in which case there will also be a second sheet in the same format. My fourth page is my branding sheet. This is where I will list my hang tag, also known as my swing tag. Then my main label, my wash care label, and some companies also have a fit sticker. If you are starting your own brand, then these are the essentials that you will have to come up with so that every product you sell will have your branding. For example, for your wash care label, you need to do a wash test on your hoodie and find out if it has to be wash only, dry clean only, machine wash cold, tumble dry low, etc. For each of these items, the material, the dimensions, the placement, any construction details, and the Pantones for the artwork need to be clearly shown. My fifth page is my spec sheet. This is where I am writing out the seam-to-seam measurements and more of each part of my hoodie. This sheet will help my manufacturers determine how the patterns need to be created and eventually how much fabric needs to be bought to produce my final bulk. An easy way of doing this, if you do not already know the measurements of your hoodie, is to buy an actual hoodie sample and measure out the parts and write it here. Keep in mind, however, that it is okay if these measurements do not work the first time. That is what a prototype is created for. Sample fit reviews are done and redone based on revised measurements until the garment looks the way you want it to. Now, I have only filled in the column for M or medium. Why? Because it is my sample size. For the rest of the sizes, a professional grader will have to increase or decrease the measurements I have written accordingly and then fill it in. Most garment manufacturers will themselves have graders in their team, but if not, you will have to seek out a professional grader who can complete this for you. And last but not the least, my sixth sheet is my BOM, or my bill of materials, where every raw material used has been listed, right from the main terry fabric used on the body to the sewing thread. My sheet, as you can see, has been segregated into fabrics, trims, and accessories for even better understanding. For each of these, the description, color, quantity, product codes, suppliers, and most importantly, the cost has been mentioned, because this is, of course, a bill. Looking at the total raw materials cost, I can determine a good profit margin and come up with an effective pricing strategy for my hoodie. Now, this sheet can be done on Microsoft Excel, because working with charts and tables on Adobe Illustrator can be such a cumbersome process. Excel also has the feature of formulae, which you can quickly use to calculate totals. Should you have a more complex garment than a hoodie, it would be more efficient to do the BOM on Excel. In larger companies, the BOM is put together by a technical designer, not a fashion designer. But once again, if you are starting your own brand and do not have a technical designer to do this, you can simply put together this list by yourself. Another optional tip is to include a column with pictures of all these items, especially trims, which will help you and your manufacturer easily keep track of and identify items respectively. And that is all, guys. It's really not that bad, is it? I hope I have explained the details clearly, but if you have any doubts at all, you can list it in the comments and I will revert to you ASAP. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next week.